So what do you call a cow with two legs? Lean beef. Because he's leaning, he's only got two legs. Lean beef.
Perfect.
Hello there, broskies. The Turk Hassan back here again with something I should have done ages ago, but better late than never. On today's episode, we are reviewing the New Balance 2002R Mirage Grey. So when it comes to top 10 sneakers that I've purchased this year, this is defo up there as one of them. And yes, I've spoken about the 2002R countless times on this channel, so I'm not really going to go over it too much as a silhouette, but I'm more going to focus on this colorway itself. Now, I wasn't going to do this review just because of how late it is, but at the same time, I have to talk about this shoe. It's right up there in terms of my most worn shoe of the year, so I have to talk about it. But starting off with the box, of course, it does come standard with the New Balance Grey box. I'm not kind of mad at it, of course, even though it's the protection pack, it is still a GR colorway. So I am kind of used to it by now. But the product sticker itself does say M2002RDD. And yes, I went for my normal UK9. Now the protection pack, as popular as the first one is, the second one I feel didn't really hit it off as well. I feel like a lot of people felt like this colorway especially was more of a ripoff of the rain clouds. And it did actually work out for me. I couldn't get the rain cloud at retail and I'm not going to pay resale for them. Just because those prices are an absolute mazza. So this pair I've actually doubled up on. What the hell? That sounds Turkish. But this pair though, I actually managed to double up on, and they are still restocking till this day. I'm going to leave some purchase links as well, just in case you do want to grab a pair. But at the moment, they are a pretty easy buy. But going back to what I was saying, I feel like a lot of people like the navy colorway out of this pack. There was that orange pair too, but that one is a bit too loud for me. And believe me, broskies, I like my loud shoes. Two other colorways did release after those three though. There was the lilac and that violet, I think it was as well, but it was more of a purple and then a blue. Both of them were absolutely banging. I did like the blue pair more than the purple. The purple for me is a little bit too feminine. And some might argue against that, but it's just how I feel. But anyway, if you're going for a pair of these, you might just be thinking about how they fit and the sizing. These for me, in terms of my UK sizing, I always go true to size with a 2002R. And this Mirage Grey is no different. Right, broskies, let's have a butcher's hook to see what these are made of. So of course, the refined future pack has always been something different from your regular 2002R. It was only called the protection pack by an actual retailer. I can't remember the name, but they actually called it that. But inspired by beating up New Balance sneakers, they really wanted to go for an age look to it. So if you wanted to beat them up, they wouldn't really change in appearance. They'd just look normal. And that's exactly why I have been running these to the ground. But of course, we've got that cutout look to the upper, which I'm such a fan of. We do have that premium suede to the overlays in that dark Mirage Grey with hits of teal around the shoe. Now, in terms of premium feel, these are more on a level of a 990 V3. That's how good this suede actually feels. Now, what makes this sneaker such a wearable and great shoe for a daily beater is how breathable and comfortable it is. It's so much more breathable because we have that mesh on the toe box in that sort of cutout style. And some 2002Rs don't really have that. The only thing I can sort of complain about is the lack of 3M on this shoe, but at the same time, because of the unique look to it, on the other end, I don't think it needs it. Of course, on both sides though, we do have the N logo. Now, just above the toe box though, we do have that N logo again. And then this sneaker does come with one set of dark grey laces. Now, the tongue in itself is of course mostly in mesh, but towards the top, we do have that synthetic leather in that cutout and beaten up look. And just underneath that, we do have the New Balance running logo, which is very faint to see. But of course, underneath the tongue itself, we do have that exposed foam. Now, we do have that soft cotton on the sock liner, which is so comfy on foot. And in the insole here, it is mostly in white with the teal New Balance branding towards the back. Now, the heel counter, we've got that synthetic leather panel again, and then the suede that wraps around this New Balance logo, which is covering that exposed foam at the back. And then just on the outer side to it, we do have the 2002R logo. But moving on to this conventional 2002R midsole, it does have that lovely aged look towards the back of it. But other than that cream colour, it does come in mostly white. Apart from absorb, we do have energy technology as well, which is meant to help with shock absorbing if you wanted to take these for a run. Now the outsole here is pretty standard. We have the New Balance logo towards the back, we have the energy in the middle, and of course the black traction panels. So nothing exciting there, but the rest of the shoe does turn heads. Right broskies, what are we thinking? The Mirage Grey Protection Pack, is this a buy or a buy? Now there's very few sneakers in someone's collection where they can just leave by the door and whack on and just go out with whatever outfit they're wearing. And this sneaker for me is one of them. No matter what I'm wearing, whether it's shorts, trousers, cargos, whatever else, these go with them. Mostly down to the looks and the comfort to this shoe, but that's exactly what you need. Honestly, one of the hardest parts of my day is deciding what to wear in terms of my shoes. And unlike some, I sort of work my way up, so I have to decide what shoes I'm wearing first, then I can work out the outfit. But anyway, I'm saying that to say, this shoe is one of my daily beaters, and I'm loving these. And yes, it's £130, it's kind of more on the expensive side for a 2002R, but for what it is, it's an absolute banger. But anyways broskies, enough waffling, put the syrup away, we are defo giving these an absolute buy. It's a sneaker I'm struggling not to wear on a daily just because I want to spread it out a little bit. But this one is such an easy wear in terms of comfort and styling. But broskies, I want you to let me know what you think. Was this Mirage Grey a sneaker you copped, or was this an absolute miss? Leave it all down below and I will pin the best comment. Anyways, my broskies, thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting. Don't forget to hit me up on IG as well because I post mostly on there. And don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share. And until the next episode, take care.